Hi guys, I'm June Vert of Matalino. Today we are going to discuss problem 012 in engineering mechanics. We're required to find the resultant of two coplanar vectors. Okay, let us start with my favorite type of solution approach, the complex mode of our calculator. Let us say that the sum of these two vectors A and B, vector A and vector B, is, let us call that vector C. Therefore, we are going to sum up vector A plus vector B. Now, to do the calculation, we're going to find the rotation of these two vectors. Let us start with the vector A. Okay, the C is equal to, for this vector A, let us start from the positive side of the x-axis in the xy plane. But take note, we're in the complex plane. We're going to rotate counterclockwise. So for the counterclockwise rotation, this is negative angle. Okay, negative 160 degrees. We have this 90 plus 70 is 160 degrees. So the definition of this angle A is 17 angle negative 160. Take note that we can also write this angle A vector A into this form. 17 angle positive 200. The positive 200 is from the positive side of the x-axis, counterclockwise rotation. Okay, 180 plus 20 or 270 minus 70, that is 200. Okay, that was how about this 44 meters per second vector? We have this from the positive side of the x-axis. We're going to rotate counterclockwise. So this is 44 angle negative 50. Again, we can also write this one according to positive rotation of angle, 44 angle, this is 310, positive 310. The positive 310 is from the positive side, you are going to rotate clockwise. Okay, so that you can see my laser pointer. We have this, from the positive side of the x-axis, you are going to rotate clockwise. Counterclockwise, that is the positive 310. Okay, input that in our calculator in complex mode. We have this result, 12.31 minus 39.52i. We're going to interpret this later on after we convert this into polar form so that we can see the magnitude of our resultant. In polar form, we have 41.39 angle 72.7 degrees. Okay, that is only an operation or a calculator. I will show you that. So we have this one. How to interpret these answers? We have this complex plane. Okay, let's say this is our horizontal and vertical axis. Then let us start with the rotation. We are going to rotate negative 72.7, meaning clockwise rotation of 72 from the positive side of the horizontal plane, horizontal axis. We are going to rotate 72 clockwise. This is the 72.7 degrees, which means that our resultant is this one. This is our resultant. Okay, this is the resultant, which we call this C. The magnitude of this C, of course, is 41.39 meters per second. What is these two quantities? 12.31 and 39.52. We have this 12.31, that is to the right, and negative 39.52, meaning that is downward. These are the components of our force, of our vector C. So we have this to the right. I will replace the color blue. To the right, this is 12.31 meters per second, and downward, indicated by this negative sign, downward, this is 39.52 meters per second. And we have the direction. Our resultant, therefore, of these two vectors A and B is equal to 41.39 degrees. And of 41.39 meters per second in the direction of 72.7 degrees downward to the left. Okay? Now, let us go to our traditional solution, which is the component method. This is the favorite of most students because of their training in the academy. Okay? Let us show that. C is equal to vector A plus vector B. Now, for the component method, let us only solve for the x component separate with the y component of the resultant. So, we have this Cx, the resultant, the x component of our resultant C. So, we are going to add the horizontal component of x and the horizontal component of B. Now, if you notice for our A and B, vector A, the measurement of the direction is from the vertical. Okay? This is measured from the vertical, the 70 degrees, while the angle B or the vector B, the angle is measured from the horizontal, 50 degrees. So be mind that because we are going to use the sine and the cosine. So for Cx, we have this horizontal component of the A. This is the horizontal component. Okay? And from this figure, from this triangle, we have this right triangle here. This is opposite of 70 degrees, meaning we are going to use sine. Sine of 70 degrees is equal to opposite. This is the AX over the hypotenuse, 17. Which means that AX is 17 sine of 70. And the direction of this is to the left, which means negative. We have a negative direction of AX. Okay, negative 17 sine of 70. Whereas the direction of the force, the horizontal component of B, the direction of BX, is actually to the right. This is the direction of the BX. This is to the right. Okay? So this is from the horizontal, which means we are going to use cosine. 44 cosine of 50. We have this positive. Using your calculator, we have this horizontal component of X, of C. Okay? Now, for the vertical component of C, let us sum up the AY and BY. Now, for the AY, we have this one. We have this AY. Okay? So, from this triangle, again, we have the cosine. We're going to use cosine of 70 degrees is equal to AY all over the hypotenuse 17. Because AY here is adjacent to 70 degrees angle. We are going to use, this is downward. Downward meaning negative. Negative 17 cosine of 70. While the BY, this is the BY. This is also downward, so this is also negative. But the angle is measured from the horizontal, so we're going to use sine. So minus 44 sine of 50 degrees. Using your calculator, we have this one. 39.52 meters per second. Now, to find the resultant, the magnitude of C, we are going to use the Pythagorean theorem, the square root of Cx squared plus Cy squared. Substitute that value. Okay? We have this magnitude of the resultant. So we are not yet complete because we need to define the direction of this vector C. Okay? So the direction of that is tangent of theta x. That is Cy all over. Since we are going to see that later on in our interpretation of these answers. So substitute arctangent of Cy all over Cx. We have this direction from the horizontal, 72.7 degrees. How to interpret these solutions, these answers? Okay? Let us interpret that, but before that, let us erase these writings here. To interpret this answer, we have this x-axis and the y-axis. Okay? The x, the positive x, the positive y. Then I will change color. Let us start with the resultant, with the components, 12.31, that is positive, which means to the right, 12.31. This is the Cx, and CY is negative, meaning downward. This is the CY. Okay? You have the magnitude. Then, we are going to project that here. The intersection of this projection is the tip of the arrowhead of our resultant, which means this is our resultant. Okay? So this is the resultant R. And our direction, this is our theta X. Okay? That's our interpretation of our solution. This is 72.7 degrees. Another way to solve this problem is by a graphical solution. Okay? The graphical solution. Let us do that. What I like in the graphical solution is the drawing, not the process. Anyway, if you are good in geometry or you want to solve this in geometry level, trigonometry in particular, this is very easy to solve. Now, let us do a little scaling of the figures. Okay? Let us respect the scale. This 17 actually is very short and 44 is very long. So we have this one. We have let us start with the 17 of the 44 meters per second and the 17 meters per second. Then we are going to do the parallelogram law to find the resultant. So we have this 17 meters per second, connect that to the tip of the 44 meters per second, and this is also the 44 meters per second. Okay? And this is our resultant. All we need to do now is to determine the magnitude and the direction of that resultant. Okay? So to do that, let us find this angle here. Let's call this angle theta. What is this angle? So very easy. If we're going to construct a horizontal line here and we are going to prolong this 44 meters per second, prolong this 17 meters per second, take note that these two are from the horizontal, their angle are given. Which means this angle from the horizontal is 20 degrees. Because this is 70 degrees from the vertical. This is the vertical line. So this is the 70 degrees. This one is 50. Or you can draw it inside so that you can see directly that theta is equal to 70 degrees. Okay, the sum of these two. This is the value of theta. Okay, we have this theta. Now we can solve for the value of R. Okay, how to solve for that value of R? Can you see the solution? We're going to use the cosine law. Okay? The cosine law. Let us start. R squared. Do you remember the cosine law? The square of one side. Let us consider this triangle. Okay? I have this dotted triangle. The cosine law of this dotted triangle. The square of one side. We have this side. We consider the side R. The square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. We have this 17. This line is 17. This projection here. 17 squared. The sum of the squares of the other two sides diminished by twice the product. Okay? Twice their product and the cosine of its included angle. The included angle between these two lines, 44 and 17, is theta, which is 70. Okay? Grab your calculator and you have this R, the answer. The square root of that value, the square root of, okay, on my calculator, this is my calculator, okay? Or I will show you in my calculator here in the screen. I have the calculator here in the screen, okay? I'll show that. Where is my calculator? You can download this from Casio. Where is my calculator? We have this mode 1 as a square root of 17 squared plus 44 squared minus 2 times 17, okay, delete 17 times 44 times the cosine of 70. I think we are in degree mode. Okay, so close parenthesis, this is the answer, 41.39, okay, 41 point, let's go back here, 41 point, 39 meters per second. How about the direction? So for the direction, we need to solve for this angle. Let's call this angle alpha. This angle here. Okay. How to solve for alpha? So we are going to use the sine law because we have these sides and angles given. One angle given, all sides are known. Okay, that is our condition now. So we have this r to the sine of theta. R to the sine of theta. This is by sine law. Is equal to this line, which is 17. 17 to the sine of what? To the sine of alpha. The opposite of this side is alpha. Therefore, the sine of alpha is equal to what? 17. Sine of theta, which is 70 degrees. Okay? Theta is 70. Take note. All over sine of, all over r, cross multiply, bring down this r to the on the opposite side of the equality. We have this 41.39. Then alpha is the arc sine of that. Okay? Alpha is what? So let us go back to our calculator. Have this one. AC. Shift sine of fraction 17 sine of 70. Okay? Then over, 41.39, and we have this value of alpha, close parenthesis, okay, 22.7, this is 22.7 degrees, meaning our rotation again from the positive side of the x-axis is this is the theta x in our previous solution. Theta x is 50 plus alpha, which is very clear. This is 72.7 degrees. So again, we have this resultant 41.39 meters per second downward to the left at 72.7 degrees from the horizontal. Okay. Now, there is an interesting solution in graphical solution using the complex mode of our calculator. I like that. I call this the cosine law by complex mode. Okay, we're going to use cosine law by complex mode. Complex number, cosine law using complex number. How to do that? Of course, we already solved this angle theta here. Okay, we've done solving this angle theta. Now, this solution actually is what we call this, similar to rotation of angles, rotation of axis. No, not similar. This is literally rotation of axis. But we are going to rotate in the direction of our one of the given. So we can define r. Let us make this 17 the x-axis of our complex number or the horizontal axis of our complex number. So to do that, we have this r. The r is equal to 44 angle 70. Okay? That 70 is from the 17 meters per second minus 17 angle 0. No need to write the angle 0. That is our reference. When we say angle 0, we are going in this direction for the angle 0. Okay? In this direction. Let us interpret that. The important here is we can interpret our solution. Okay? If we are going to do that in our calculator, and this one, we have this. First, let us set up so that our calculator is in complex mode. That is number 2 in the menu. We have this complex number format. Okay, I will put it here. 44 angle shift, that is shift angle 70. Okay, minus 17. This is our result in the 1 negative 1.95. Okay, this is not very important, but we are going to write that one. What is that? Negative. Okay. Negative 1.95, 41.35. 1.95. Angle 41. Ano yun? Not angle. Okay. Erase. Plus 41 point. What is that? 41.35i. Okay. 41 point. Let's go back. 41.35i. So this is our result. Now, let's go back to our calculator. Okay. Now, this is not meaningful. The meaningful part here is if we are going to convert this format into polar form. To do that option, actually you can go directly with the setup of the calculator so that it will display R angle theta instead of A plus BI. Okay, the default format. So I'm using this A plus BI format. That's why the result is given in this form. We have this R theta, that is number one. So this is the more meaningful na answer, 41.39, this is the magnitude, and 92.7, and we have this direction. Take note that this direction is from the 17 meters per second because that is our reference. Let us interpret this solution, okay? 41.39, you have this one, 92.7. 41.39, angle 92.7 degrees. Okay, that is our... How to interpret this solution answer in the calculator? Meaning, our magnitude of R is 41.39. This is the answer. The same as our answer in the previous, okay? And 92.7, meaning we're going to rotate. This is positive rotation, okay? We're going to rotate clockwise, okay? If we're going to extend this one. Okay, I will show you first the angle. This is the 92. This is the result of the calculator, 92.7. And minus 20 degrees. This is 20 degrees from the horizontal. So meaning, this is our theta x. Okay? The theta x. 72.7 degrees. Okay? So, we can still get the correct answer. Let us go back to our rotation. I think I can get it here because we input at this point. We have this. So, this is our positive part of our axis. So, this is the positive part of our axis because we call this... We have this 44 angle 70. So angle 70 is clockwise. This is 44 angle 70. We define this as clockwise in our rotation of axis. That's why when he gave us 92.7, we rotate also clockwise. Okay, that's it. This is our reference line or the pole in the polar graph. Okay, we define this line. I will go to the laser point. This is our polar graph, our pole in the polar graph. We define this line as 44, the length 44, angle 70. And that angle 70 is defined here as positive. That's why when we get this 92.7, we rotate here clockwise. That is also the rotation clockwise from this line downward. That is 92.7 degrees. Okay, that's it. If our reference line is the 17 meters per second, let us play this around. What if we're going to take the 44 meters per second as our reference line? Okay, how to do that? I think I need to erase all of these writings. R is instead of 44 angle 70, let us go back the put back the 70. We are going to use What is that? 17 angle 70 minus 44. Okay? Let's do the calculator. And this one. Menu. Okay. I am already in the complex mode. 17 shift angle 70 minus 44. Okay? 38.19, 15.97. I will not write that. So I am going to if you are going to write this one, we can interpret that as parallel and perpendicular to 44 meters per second. We can do that. Parallel and perpendicular. Okay? So we have this one. This is our reference, the 44. May I write that? 15.97. We are going to interpret that later on. Let's go first for the final answer. Let's go back to our calculator. And this one. Option. Then downward arrow. R theta. This is the polar form of our answer. 41.39. The same. 157.30. 41.39. Angle 137. 157.30. Okay, let us check. I'm not that. 157.30. Okay. 137. Let us erase that. Pen. 157.30. Okay. I will replace the color of my pen. This is now our reference. This is actually our reference line. And we rotate. We rotate 157. We rotate 157.3. Okay. Clockwise. Okay. If we are going to interpret that, we are going to extend this line. And we're going to extend this line here. Okay. Or we can extend it here, like we do previously. Then we have this horizontal line. And this is the rotation from this line, because we consider this as positive direction. It's hard to draw here. From here, this is the 157 pen, 157.3. So we need to solve this one for the direction. What is theta x with that definition? Okay, if we are going to interpret this input 17 angle 70 from this line, we input 17, the length is 17, the angle is 70, so we rotate clockwise from here. This is clockwise. From this point up to here is 70. Okay, this length is 17. So this is our reference line, that is 17 angle 70. So this is the positive part, so we have this one. Okay, 17 angle 70. This one, this part here. I'm out of space. Basically, this part here. From here up to this line is 70 degrees, as indicated here. 17 angle 70. That's why we call this positive rotation. We have this 157, also a positive rotation. Okay? From this line up to here is 157.30. I think that's it. So let's go back to find this theta x. What is theta x from our figure? Now, from this figure, this is 180 degrees, right? This is our alpha in our previous solution. And alpha here is equal to 180 degrees minus 157. Okay, 157.30. Okay, so 180 minus 157.30. This is the same calculator I'm using. in the screen. That is 22.7. Okay, 22.7. So very clear. We have this theta x is equal to 50 plus alpha. Okay? And that is 72.7 degrees. So again, we have this resultant of the two vectors. The resultant is, the magnitude is 41.39 meters per second downward to the left at 72.7 degrees from the horizontal. Okay? Thank you for watching and good day.